important, and that will be beneficial to the efficient and effective operation of the judiciary from the trial court up to the Supreme Court.
Thank you, Chief. The next to ask a question is Anjo Alimario, CNN Philippines.
Hi, Chief.
Yes. Thank you. I think they should look at my record. I've been in government for 45 years now, and by the time I retire, I would have served 45 years and 8 months in government. I worked in the Supreme Court for 5 years as a young lawyer. I transferred to the Department of Justice, where I worked for 19 years. I was promoted to the Sandigan Bayan. In 1997, I became the presiding justice of the Sandigan Bayan in 2004. So I served for 10 years in the Sandigan Bayan and occupied the highest position there, which is the presiding position of the presiding justice. And after that, I was promoted to the Supreme Court, and I've been working here since 2007. So I think people should just look at my track record, my service, long service in the judiciary, and I don't think that one incident, like you mentioned, would have been enough for me to be elevated to this highest position in the judiciary.
Thank you, Chief. Anjo, you have a related follow-up?
I think we should all move on and work together for the good of our judiciary. Let's put the past behind us. But of course, we should not forget the lessons that we learned in that event in the history of the judiciary.
Thank you. But next to us is Dano Tingkungko, GMA Network.
Thank you.
Ma'am, when we look at the duration of your tenure, you will be retiring on October 8th, and it will be a little over a month. What legacy do you want to leave behind? What mark do you want to leave behind in the Castro court?
You know, all of us in the court should not begin working when we become Chief Justice. We should work as early as the time that we are first appointed to the court, and that was what I did. So whatever legacy I may leave behind when I retire is not the product of 2 months or weeks. I've been working on this for many years already. In fact, even when the position of Chief Justice was beyond my imagination, I was already working on many projects which I want to be done when I retire, not as chief, but as an associate justice. And I am very happy that I did that, because I will just have to continue this project that I have started years before my retirement in October. For instance, I'll give you an example. I'm the chair of the Committee on Family Courts and Juvenile Concerns. And I was appointed in September of 2014. And I started working as early as that to find out what's wrong, why don't we have regular family courts. From 1997, that was about 18 years ago, our family courts are regional trial courts designated as family courts, although family courts were already created in 1997. So I worked vigorously to see to it that regular family courts are funded by Congress. And true enough, in 2015, we were able to convince Congress to fund family courts beginning 2016. So what we did was to see to it that we recommend the organization of family courts in batches, because it is physically or impossible to do all of this, well, throughout the country one time. So we decided to do it by batches, and we were successful in 2016. Congress funded 48 family courts, regular family courts, no longer regional trial courts, but genuine family courts as created by law. And in 2017, we were able to secure funding for additional 50 family courts. And in 2018, we have another batch of 39 family courts. And after that, another batch in 2019, consisting of 50 family courts. So as you see, I will not be working only for 2 months. I've been working for years, since 2009 for the computerization of the judiciary. And since 2014, I've been working for the organization of regular family courts and also the reforms in the rules, Supreme Court rules pertaining to family cases and cases involving children in conflict with the law. And I cannot mention any more here because there were so many of them. We were able to secure the approval of the court and bank. My committee on family courts and juvenile concern were able to secure so many reforms with respect to the processes followed by the family courts and with respect to the rules applicable to children in conflict with the law.